So today we have Krishna Teja here. He is my co-worker and he recently purchased a white S3. I think he has been using for more than 2 months. Here I have a pebble blue S3. We are here to get his experience on the S3 and the features which he loved the most and any improvements we can suggest. So Teja, when did you actually buy your S3?
I bought it in somewhere in the end of May.
Okay.
During the S3 launch, I have already pre-booked it.
Okay.
So, in the night, they called me and they said, sir, tomorrow there is a launch, are you aware of it? I said no. And then casually they told me that I was one of the lucky members to be selected in a lucky dip, and they would be giving it from the hands of gorgeous Shruti Asim, South Indian Giran. So, I was very excited about that, and getting it from her is, and I feel I was on cloud nine at that point.
Okay. So, there was a huge price slash after the recent launch of the S3. So, did you find was it a right decision to pre-book the phone? Because
soon after 1 week, the prices were down in many other websites other than the e-store. They reduced the price and they were giving it at much lower price.
38
but one thing why I went ahead buying the phone was, Samsung was giving a free Bluetooth headset at the time.
Okay.
It's 2400 rupees worth, and then also they have assured they have an assured gift for the customers who purchase it earlier.
Okay.
And they have given me this nice flip cover along with that 7 days after the purchase.
Okay.
And apart from that, we also have that Vodafone 3G plan.
Correct.
3GB limit for 2 months.
Correct.
It was very good.
So it's 6GB for 2 months.
6GB for 2 months, and it's free.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah, even I am using it and it offers great speed actually.
So still after that, the prices were reduced. The total sum assured gift, even than that, the price was reduced.
Okay.
Then Samsung came up with a surprise celebratory voucher worth 1500 rupees saying that the launch was success, so they are very happy to announce a 1500 rupees voucher.
Mm-hmm.
So with that, I have bought this C-Pen.
Okay.
It is currently out of stock and very happy to be one of the proud owners of C-Pen.
Okay, so is it good playing with the C-Pen? Is it sensitive and...
Yeah, obviously it just simulates the finger touch though.
Okay.
But it has a very low surface area with which you can touch precisely. Even when you are working on the internet, small points, your finger touches more spaces.
So like it's even quite accurate and pinpoint to a position.
Pinpoint to a position, yeah.
Correct.
Even while doing the swipe keyboard also, your finger tends to touch 2 or 3 keys at the time.
Right.
But with this you can be more precise.
Okay, so talking about the phones, what was your earlier phone from which you shifted and what was the main reason for the shift?
I had an earlier Nokia 6303.
Okay.
Classic phone, which is not a smartphone either, but it's a very good phone. But after that I wanted to upgrade to a smartphone. Let me cope up with the technology, there are so many things going on around. So I just wanted to take a look at all the smartphones. Then I have done some research and I had to wait for S3 later on.
Okay, so we see that you bought a smartphone and you must have done initial market research quite a lot. So what was the main reason of inclination towards S3 and what inclined you towards buying S3 and no other smartphone?
Frankly speaking, I haven't had any physical hands-on experience on S3 because it wasn't there in the market.
Okay.
I'm doing a pre-book on that. So, but I had some trust developed with Samsung, looking at Samsung earlier phones.
Okay.
My friends use a Samsung Galaxy S.
Yeah.
So there are other phones, even S2 was a huge hit. So Samsung had that kind of a trust with us. So it gives us some kind of encouragement and credibility with which we can go and do a pre-book on Samsung phones.
Okay. So, talking about the phone and the S3, can you give us a quick glimpse of the features which you use daily and which gain your attention? I see you are a cyclist and you cycle a lot. So, what are any features in S3 which help you during your adventure rides?
Yeah, speaking about Android, I don't need to speak much because Android has very other lots of applications.
Right.
It's very robust and I have many applications like Endomondo and Ferobike, with which I can track the routes which I am going, I can measure the calories.
Uh-huh.
And along with that I also have the Google Maps, everything, the latitude with whom I am riding, I can see the position of him where he is riding.
Okay.
And also I can track in which path I am going, how many calories are being burnt. So there are a lot of other things. Apart from that, I also have a very good rear camera from S3.
Okay.
So 8 megapixel camera, and it also comes up with so many features like the best shot, worst shot.
So you can take the photos in the motion and you can identify them.
And also have the social tag feature with which I can take the photo and instantly I can tag some person.
Okay.
And I can upload it in Facebook or Twitter and whatnot.
So what all other features were you using? Like we have smart stay, smart alert. There are so many smart features in this phone. So
yeah, there are many other things like smart stay, as you said, smart alert, direct call, which is one thing. If you are looking at the message and put it near, direct call is something which I use on a regular basis. And apart from that, there is a notification LED, multicolored notification LED, which is helping me a lot. Without even touching my phone, I can see the status.
So yeah, even without unlocking the phone, by just seeing the LED, you can identify.
Know the status of the phone without even unlocking.
Okay. So there are so many features and everything is so smart about S3. So, but still, if I have to ask you one of that perfect feature which you feel is great actually, so what it would be, if you can show that to us in action.
I do travel a lot, and whenever I'm traveling, I'm a music freak and I tend to listen to so many songs.
Okay.
So one thing that interests me in S3 is the Music Square application.
Okay.
Wherein in the music player, there is an application called Music Square.
Okay.
It selects the song and I can select any song based on my mood.
Okay. So basically, like when you are cycling, you will select an exciting mood, and when you are sleeping, you can select a calm mood. So the song should be playing as per the mood and the current scenario of the person. So can you show this in action if you have a zoom in the screen?
Sure.
Yeah. So he's using a C pen, which is a capacitive enabled pen, and it works only
so
with
like
the
this. With Music Square, I have four options.
Okay.
Passionate, exciting, joyful, and calm. Mm-hmm. And based on these, whatever genre you select, it selects the song.
Okay.
So after a hectic day at work, I want to listen to some soothing music. I can select all calm. See, you can get all songs which are having a calm mood.
Okay.
So I have over 800 songs that are linked in. I can just, based on the genre, I can select if I have passionate.
So, does it also show the...
I have a combining thing.
Multiple moods, right. So, does it also show the genre of a single song if I want to identify that?
Sure. You can go to the albums,
okay.
Select whatever song you want. Dead by April, there is one song, Losing You.
Correct.
So, you select the song. Again, click on Music Square, it will show you what the genre is.
Okay.
So, it's somewhere between exciting and passionate.
Passionate. Okay.
So, like this, you can know the particular song. As I keep on listening to it, I get acquainted with what kind of a genre it is.
Right.
So, if I want to listen to certain songs, I select it based on that.
Okay. So, it's actually a very good feature, Music Square, which lets you play the music as per your current mood.
And here I also have the Sound Alive feature, wherein I can select any of these things. I mean, it has various other options to play the music,
right,
based on my mood.
Okay, so I can see you bought a white S3, and here we have a pebble blue S3. So what was your reason of inclination to get a white S3, and why not wait for a pebble blue version?
I was looking at the pictures by the time I was doing the preview.
Right.
I was very much impressed with the color white. Earlier I had some dark color phones.
Okay.
But white looked very much appealing to me, and then it comes with a polycarbonate. So you can see there are no fingerprints that are seen, it doesn't get dirty.
Yeah.
So many people are under the misconception that white phone gets dirty.
Right.
But coming up with a polycarbonate thing and a Gorilla Glass,
uh-huh,
I don't see any scratches or kind of...
So some people were skeptical about the design also. So what are your comments on the design and the quality of the material which they have used in designing this phone?
Yeah, I particularly like the quality because it comes with a polycarbonate at the behind. It's
okay.
Indestructible. Nothing will happen to this, and it comes with the Gorilla Glass too.
Right.
I don't even have a screen guard for this.
Mm-hmm.
I've been using for the past 2 months. You can see there
is no scratch even on this phone.
Scratch on the phone.
Yeah.
So that is one thing. And apart from that, if you see all the buttons, you can reach with a single hand.
Yeah.
So
every
button
is
reachable. There's a power on button and volume up and down button.
Correct.
And all these you can reach with a single hand. So it's very user friendly, you can use it with a single hand and easily operate it. Not that it has a 4.8 inch screen,
right.
It means that it's not like a tablet.
Right.
You
can reach
tablet.
All the buttons and play with the phone and do all the tasks with just one hand, right?
Yes.
And so the fingers are reachable at every part of the phone and you can reach all the features in there. So what was your overall experience, if you have to tell it in a nutshell, how did you feel as the owner of S3?
So far I didn't have any cognitive dissonance kind of feeling.
Okay.
Like I have bought an expensive thing, yeah, I should have bought that phone, it's coming with a cheaper rate with all the quality.
Right.
So till now I didn't have that feeling. I was very happy with S3, and I didn't feel any other cheaper phone would give me such kind of features and such kind of amount of credibility or such kind of performance.
Okay, so is it, can we say, is it to the level that it can even replace your laptop to a bit, some extent?
Yeah, now these days I am not even using my laptop.
Okay.
For the past 2 months I am more inclined to this. I can sit in a position I want, I can sleep while watching videos.
Right.
It also has a nice pop-up video.
Pop-up and play.
Pop-up and
whenever so watching. You can do multiple
movie,
tasks, seeing the movie also.
Watching the movie, don't need to stop.
Okay.
So
Teja is not even using his laptop for quite few days, and S3 has, I think, totally replaced your laptop.
You can say.
Yeah. So it has a quad-core processor, it has the RAM, the hardware is comparable to a laptop. So I think it can even replace the laptop.
Yeah, sure. It also comes with a 50 GB Dropbox limit.
Right.
So it's one thing, I can share my phone, all my files,
right,
and get it whatever I want.
Mm-hmm.
It's like I have 16 GB internal memory, I have one 16 GB SD card,
right,
and 50 GB of Dropbox.
Right.
It's more or less almost some 80 GB what I have. I can have everything on that. It's more or less efficient than laptop.
So here we have a geek who uses all the possible features of S3, he has extracted all the juice out of X3, and I think the battery, how will you rate your battery? Does it live up to your expectations?
It comes with a 2100 mAh battery.
Okay.
It's pretty decent for your phone.
Uh-huh.
And apart from that, it also has various other options like power saving mode, everything.
Correct.
And I tend to use it efficiently because whatever I want, I will just switch it on.
Okay.
Unnecessarily switching on so many features will obviously reduce. For a phone like this, it has so many features. If you switch on everything,
uh-huh,
it obviously gets down on your battery. So I tend to use it whenever I don't need a screen rotation, I turn it off, haptic feedback, many other options, and already it has that screen saving mode enabled.
Okay, so if I ask you a quick rating for the phone out of 10, so what it would be?
I would give it 8 out of 10.
Okay, so why 8? What missed those 2 points? Is there any room of improvement which you like to suggest to Samsung if they can actually work upon and through an update or any way, or maybe in the next phone they can fix it?
Whenever I take this phone to someone, people are more interested about S4.
Okay, yeah.
Because something which you say and you do it, it does it, it's like a great...
It brings the machine closer to the humans, I think.
Yes, it's like designed for humans, and what is the feature, that feature that is not there in all the smartphones is S4. So, but I have a few problems with S4. Being an Indian, it doesn't recognize all the Indian sounds properly. I know it's a little difficult for the people to do it because it's more or less a personalization for the Indians.
Correct.
But still, being an Indian, I would like it to be having the database of certain Indian sounds.
Correct. So, even I have problem calling my Indian friends with the Indian names, obviously. Because S-Voice is not much happy, I think, with the Indian names. It doesn't understand those names quite accurately.
Yeah. And one more thing, it should have some kind of offline support. More or less like voice commands, what we have for phones.
No, basic voice commands can have,
yeah,
offline support.
So, basic voice commands can be integrated with S-Voice.
Okay.
I don't say it's a shortcoming.
Right.
But it can be a feature which would be very, very much useful.
Enhancement.
Because people wouldn't have GPRS or enabled throughout the night.
Correct.
It would obviously eat up your battery.
Okay, so I think these all features can just be corrected through a normal software update.
Software.
If Samsung comes up with a software update, then I think they can fix this feature.
Yes.
So that's from the words of Teja, his experience on S3, and he's quite satisfied with his S3. He pre-booked it, he's been using it for 2.5 months. Thank you, Teja, for your time.
Thanks so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much.